of this satsang at the Turiya level?
All experience happen at Turiya level only. You means, I means, if your mind is not experiencer, mind is powered by consciousness.
That is a stage where I have overcome the ego, then only that thing is the ego is still holding there strong. Then the ego also has a
when everything is mithya, how why you can say ego is satya?
No, no, no. Because ego is still existing.
Okay.
I have not overcome ego.
So when you say, I have not overcome ego, means who is not overcome ego? Me means who?
Consciousness.
Me means who?
Consciousness. Since he asked about the universal mind, you said individual mind. No, you said, when I say individual consciousness, it means the BMI.
Consciousness reflected in BMI.
Okay. Now, what is the difference between this individual mind and individual consciousness?
That's individual mind has under the illusion of I am separate.
Okay.
It's like a whirlpool in an ocean or in a river. A river is there. Whirlpool is not separate from river, but it keeps on going in circles.
Okay.
Like that, individual consciousness goes in some circles because of the wrong understanding. So tell me, what question, what Murali, what your question you have? Huh? Smita? Venkat?
You started with the topic of self-inquiry. This is completely understood. Self-inquiry is limited by the, you know, the mind is the major stumbling block.
It's not a stumbling block, it's an instrument.
It always, you know, that we talk about the doubt. There's no doubt. The guru vakya is, so there can't be any doubt. So that mind, you know, the self-inquiry, if you can tell us more about
self-inquiry. This is the self-inquiry. I'm asking you, when you say, I am seeing, first I ask the question, who is I am? Then you said, seeing, wall, means what you're seeing. This is the self-inquiry, no?
The chitta keeps coming. Impressions keep coming and create that.
That's a past.
The past.
That's the past.
These impressions, you know, depends on how each of.
That's what you have accumulated so far.
It accumulated. So all that will keep coming quite often. Because in every situation, this has to work.
Every situation, you have to realize that you are only dealing with consciousness. At least now onwards, you have to really live in that way. So to gradually, over a period of time, chitta, whatever is there, stored will get repaired.
So this at a waking state, this is very good. Working at a dream level.
Dream level only is what comes from the impressions. What you had a waking state, only impression comes as impression in dream states. If your waking state experience is understood in a different light, dream also will undergo changes, no? In my dream, anybody comes, I'll teach them, who are you? I'll ask the question, who are you? And that fellow disappears. A ghost comes, I'll ask you, who are you? A god comes and asks you, who are you? I'll ask you, who are you? That guy disappears.
Just one more. In today's satsang, what is this, how do you explain experience and awareness?
Awareness is the knower. Understand? Awareness is the knower. When the knower takes the form of the object, then the knowledge is there. That knowledge is called experience.
So the same in the banana example. So I am seeing the banana.
You are seeing the banana.
Yeah. You said I am becomes the consciousness.
That's correct. I am the consciousness.
Okay. That's the experience of awareness. That's the experience of awareness. I am
is awareness.
Awareness.
And
what is that experience?
I am is awareness.
Okay.
Awareness is always there.
And then experience again.
Seeing is the experience.
Seeing is the experience.
Right?
Okay.
And seen is the object. In knowledge, seer, seen and experience merge into one.
Okay.
Okay. Then only the knowledge happens. That we call as experience.
So experience is for sense organs.
Experience is when seer and seen become one. Then there is something called experience.
But if there is no sense organ, there is nothing.
Then if there is no sense organ, that experience is because of sense organs, we are calling it experience of sense organs. If there is no sense organ, also seer and seen are one. Then there is no experience, but there is only knowledge.
So maybe the experience is through sense organs.
Experience is through three sense organs, but then there is experience alone is reality, is there, because seer and seen have become one.
For a small deviation.
On deviation.
Yeah. You said that both waking and dreaming state is our experience of impressions, our impressions.
Huh. No. Waking state is a projection of consciousness. Okay. Dream state is a
Impressions.
Now,
is it belongs to the past life also, dreaming state?
No, dreaming state is impressions. No, impressions.
Present,
impressions life. Can be from anywhere, past anywhere. Life or anywhere. It's past all stored life. Record. It's all your CDs.
Yeah.
It's all your
folders,
memory sticks.
But waking state that doesn't happen.
Waking state also happens. It may know. Whatever you are having, you married her, no?
Yeah.
So, are you sure that you are not related to her in the past life? Because all relationships are coming from many lifetimes. Others, why only marry her? So all relationships are karmic relationships in some way. That happens in waking state also.
Why only her is to learn the lesson?
Huh? What?
Why only her is to learn the lesson?
Why are the lessons? Some lessons she has to teach. Past life. Pending lessons.
Unfinished
lessons.
Agenda.
Okay.
So,
yeah. What is that?
So, if I am the consciousness, and everything else is consciousness, and I'm just taking the body to project the world, then how does the universe know to whom to give all the karmic impressions to? If everything is consciousness, how will it know?
Yeah, there are so many bodies. No, universe, you have...
Because I leave this body once I'm dead.
Huh?
I leave this body, right? I won't have this
body. No. Individual consciousness is there. Individual consciousness is consciousness reflected in the body. That individual consciousness will gather all the impressions. It will go from one body to other body until all the experiences are over. That individual consciousness has an identity. Until it merges, realizes the non-duality.
But isn't that famous theory
of consciousness? Okay. The water, there's an ocean. Where is the water? There is a river, there is a water, and there is a lake, there is a water. All are water? Then how they are different? There is a separation, boundary. So similarly, individual consciousness puts a boundary for itself, saying that I am the body, mind and intellect. So as long as that individual consciousness puts that boundary and lives in that way, it gathers impression. It goes from one body to other body. That's why it's called jiva. When the jiva realizes that I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am pure consciousness, it merges with the ocean, infinite consciousness. Okay, then there is no impressions. It's merged with the, when the impressions of the, when lake merges with the ocean, what is there? Nothing.
So there will be no boundary.
Huh?
There will be no boundary.
There will be no boundary. As long as your individual identity, that a karma will come to you only. You know, courier guy comes, knows an address. If you give address, proper address, it will come. Consciousness doesn't know it.
Just use the word infinite consciousness. It's different from universal consciousness.
No, all these are words. Don't get it. Consciousness. Okay. So, any other questions? What, Subbu? You only created so many Advaita t-shirts, huh?
There is no doubt in Advaita. Doubt is in the correlation between the universe and the individual.
There is no difference between the universe and individual. Okay, the only thing is individual is a viewpoint in the universe. When the viewpoint changes, individual is the universe.
Yeah, so that self is always separate. It is never individual or universe. It is just there. It's always separate. But when the consciousness is projecting a universe, and the jiva is experiencing it, so how does that energy flow and how is that?
Which energy flows?
Like it's again, when you say consciousness is projecting the world, it's again a pranic movement, right?
Hmm.
So, how does it create an individual experience? It's the same prana, right? Like, when Jiva projects a dream, you're saying it's a subtle pranic movement. In the waking state, it's again a pranic movement, right? So, how does that pranic movement create an individual experience? That experience of duality.
So, this you are coming to ask me the question of Maya. Okay? It's nothing but the secrets of Maya. How the Maya happens.
Yeah.
How the time and space and individual are created.
Yeah.
So that is part 3 of the serial. Next Sunday. Okay, now so far it's only inquiry into yourself. Now inquiry into Maya is next week.
Because self is pretty straightforward, it's pure existence.
Self is pure existence. So we'll inquire into the nature of Maya next class. That will take about 1.5 hours again. Okay? Nature of Maya has 3 aspects: individual, time and space. What is that? We'll inquire into that. Today itself, many heads are. I am not seeing the light in many eyes. What is that? Any questions? Okay. So, if there are no questions, let us go for meditation.
One question.
One question.
You are saying that Tripoti dissolves in knowledge, right?
Tripoti?
Seer, seen and seeing.
Hmm.
If there's no consciousness to take that form, there's no knowledge.
Hmm.
So are there multiple points of knowledge then? Because every jiva will have a Tripoti of his own.
Every jiva will have a Tripoti, okay. So? Yeah.
So if many jivas are seeing a wall, for example, so are there multiple points of knowledge or they dissolve?
The consciousness, a single consciousness, one consciousness operating through many jivas.
Right.
Mm. One consciousness operating through many jivas, but each jiva is wearing different lenses, glasses.
Okay.
So the world appears variety, multiple variety, yeah. Multiple things.
So the different glass will be made of
impressions.
I think one thing you have the desire.
Desire.
That Agni and the really.
The fire.
I think that one is probably he has forgotten. There was one.
I also have forgotten.
You said that conscience is there, that divine desire. So from there the manifestation started.
No, that we will take. Manifestation will take in the next class.
Okay.
His question is about Maya.
Yeah. So no, but that spark we have within us.
No, he is asking the question how it is operating. So you are saying source of that.
Because
now he is asking how time and space and individual experience happens. So that is another class. Actually, the intricate secrets of Maya. Self-realization, Maya is another aspect. Okay. So let us go for meditation.